going to be. We are at some of those crucial pivot levels as far as the banking names are concerned. And you're going to see a lot of reactions. We'll discuss those names with our experts as well. Manish Sharma from Derivative Trading Academy also joins in this morning in our studios. Manish, morning. What's the sense? A good start to the August series after a very dismal July series. Can we expect some bit of momentum building? Or again, it's that 11,400, 11,200 zone that we'll be confined to.
If you see the overall data, we have started seeing the shortcoming rally from the lower levels of around 11,200. 11,200 is acting as a strong support now, and we might see a short covering pullback in August series first week. So we are expecting a pullback for a target of around 11,450 to 11,500. So for a short-term trader, it can be a very good buy call around the current levels with a stop loss of 11,250 and for a short-term target of around 11,450 to 11,500.
Right, so that's with regards to Nifty 50 as well as we speak. Another stock that we will be watching out for will be an ICICI Bank in today's day of trade because the numbers have been pretty stable. The asset quality has improved and clearly the anticipation is that probably there could be a gap up opening. If that is the case, the impact on, you know, Bank Nifty is going to be crucial as well. What would your trading calls be?
My first call is sell call in Vedanta. Vedanta, if you see 170, 175 is a strong resistance for the stock and we are seeing a strong short build up around those levels. So we are expecting a downfall in Vedanta. 150 can be a possible target. So sell in Vedanta with a stop loss at 171 and for a short term target from 150. Next call is sell call in Havells. Havells has given poor results and it is currently trading below the psychological level of around 700. So Havells can be a very good short around 700 with a stop loss at 720 and look for the positional target of around 650. And last call is buy call in ICICI Bank. ICICI Bank 400 is a very strong base price formation and we are seeing a strong long build up around those levels. 450 to 470 can be a positional target in ICICI Bank. So ICICI Bank is a buy with a stop loss at 410 and look for the short term target of around 450.
Right. So ICICI Bank features prominently on our experts' radar as far as the trading session goes. So definitely watch out for that. But Brijesh, you know, Reliance Industries, now this is an important one. It's fallen below its 200 DMA and it's one of the key drags for the markets in the last 1 month as well. Considering that Reliance has now moved towards that, could the other large... Manish, Sun Pharma as well, you know, we've seen some positivity build into this counter, but it seems to have run into a wall now. So, good bounce coming in from 370 to about those 430, 440 levels. It's still holding up at these higher levels. Is there a possibility of a further up move in Sun Pharma?
Definitely. We have seen a reversal in Sun Pharma from around 370 to 400 odd levels. And now the stock is consolidating around current levels. But we can expect a target of around 480 to 500 in the upcoming trading sessions once the it comes out of the consolidation phase. So any bounce, correction around 430, 440 levels will be a very good buy in Sun Pharma with a stop loss at 420 and for a positional target of around 480 to 500.
Right, so that's with regards to Sun Pharma that we should be watching out for in trade as we speak. But beyond that, a couple of other counters that could see some bit of a negative reaction is a JSW Steel, a weak set of numbers that have been reported on this counter. In fact, the bancher had already mentioned with regards to where the entire metal pack is concerned. But especially on a JSW Steel, Manish, what are charts indicating?
Stock has already given a 52-week fresh breakdown with a strong short build-up. 250 was a psychological support and it has already broken that. We might see around 8-10% downfall in the stock. So we can expect a target of around 220 in the August series itself. So any bounce back around 250 levels will be a very good short with a stop loss at 260 and for a short-term target from 220 to 230.
Right. Brijesh, talk about Vedanta as well. It'll be reacting to its numbers today. We've seen weakness come back to this one. Had seen a bit of a bounce back, but it's under pressure, fell 4% on Friday as well.
See, Vedanta, till the stock has not been trading above 175, 178, it's looking weak. And if I'm not mistaken, today's even Manish has said has given a sell call on it. So any rise should be used for going short because charts are not promising, but only thing is that use rise for going short. 166, 168 is the level for going short with the stop loss of 175 and play for the target of 145 to 148 as a positional bet has been concerned.
Right. So that's with regards to where Vedanta is concerned, as we've been talking about. But beyond that, in terms of other few counters, Havells India, weak set of numbers, Escorts, weak set of numbers, Vodafone Idea, weak set of numbers, as well as Mahindra Life. Taking these four stocks into consideration, Manish, anything in terms of a short strategy? Because on the back of the weakness, there is a possibility of a gap down opening. But anything that you would want to recommend?
If you see, ICICI Bank already given a very good numbers, and tomorrow I think there is a result of Axis Bank. Axis Bank also expected numbers are very good. So Axis Bank can be a very good buy levels around current levels. So Axis Bank we can buy 750 call option around 17 rupees with a stop loss at 8 rupees and for a target of around 35 to 40. We can expect a 5 to 6% upside move in Axis Bank from the current levels.
Right. So maybe a bit of divergent trend could be expected on an Axis Bank in trade today. Watch out for both Axis as well as an ICICI. You've had SBI that came under a bit of pressure.